Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Orchis Yosher. Rav Chaim Kanievsky is bringing down many different Maimari Chazal statements that the sages made that talk about how careful we have to be with the negative Middos, the bad character traits that a person, God forbid, might develop. And he writes, Valkino Omru, on when it comes to jealousy, it says in Chazal, Atzmoisav Markivin, one's bones will rot through the jealousy that they have. And that person who knows what jealousy feels like, that there's this inner rotting that goes on with inside of them where they're feeling so bad about other people and so negative towards others, it actually causes the bones to rot. And further it says, Va'akino va'ataiva va'akovoid, jealousy and taiva, base lust and desire, covered and running after your own personal honor and glory, removes a person from the world, a person who lives in the world of kina. He's not in the world. Why? Because if you're jealous of other people, that means you can't be happy with what you have, and that's your world. The world that Hashem has given you, the brachas that Hashem has given you, the pleasure, the goodness that Hashem has given you, if you're jealous of what other people have, you can't enjoy what HaKadosh Baruch Hu has sent your way and what He's bestowed upon you. And therefore, someone who is enraptured in a world of keen of jealousy, he's out of the world. He's not here. Why? Because he's not in the world that Hashem has given him. He's always thinking about something else. And when it comes to sina, hatred, baseless hatred of another Jew, it says, the Gemara tells us that sinas chinam, hatred of another Jew, is equivalent to a person who transgresses idol worship, illicit sexually relations, ushvichas damim, and killing someone. And that's why the first Beis HaMikdash was destroyed, because of the big three, because of the idol worship, the illicit relations, and killing. And the second Beis HaMikdash was killed for only one thing, sinas chinam, which is baseless hatred. That's how terrible and devastating it is. V'omru, and it says further, hamal bim penei chaver barabim, someone who embarrasses his friend publicly, ein lechelik lo'olam haba, you have no portion in the world to come. You killed a person, you destroy a person by embarrassing them, by saying something in front of other people that's going to make their face turn white or make their face turn red. You lose your share in the world to come. U'bali lashon hara ein lahem chelik lo'olam haba, and so too people that speak continuously words of lashon hara, of gossip, they also have no portion in the world to come. You destroyed so many people's lives and so many people's worlds, and you cast negative aspersions on so many different people. Hashem says, look what you did to people here in this world. Look at the terrible, terrible ruach, spirit that you caused amongst bnei adam, amongst people here in this world. You have no portion waiting for you in the world to come. And someone who has a bad nickname, an embarrassing nickname that he calls his friend, something which puts him down. Hey, Shorty, how are you? The guy is a short man. So you call him Shorty, and you call him Schnazola. The guy's got a big nose, and you put the person down as a result of it. Yored legehenem ve'ino oile. This person will go down to Gehenem, down there in that hot, fiery world. Ve'ino oile, not going to come up. That's for just calling a person by a nickname. Yes, Chazal are telling us how careful we have to be with our words, how we treat other people, how we act towards other people, in order to be able to engender peace and harmony and love amongst Klal Yisrael. Veshenosno chitosam ha'eretz chayim, someone who places their fear and their terror on the land amongst people. You impose on people and you put fear on them. People are frightened of you. You're going to go down to the Gehenim, to the depths of that fiery world down there, where there's so much spiritual suffering and pain that a person will have to go through, and it will be Lidoridoris for generations and generations to come. And therefore, how careful a person has to be with the Midais Ra'ois, with the negative character traits that a person has, to overcome them, to fix them, to put them into a place of refined nobility, in order that he can avoid chas v'chalila these terrible punishments and warnings that the Chazal, our sages, give to us based on their empirical knowledge of the Ratzon Hashem of what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants for Klal Yisrael. Have a wonderful day, a day of tikkun, of fixing the negative traits and accentuating the midos tovos, the positive traits that HaKadosh Baruch Hu has imbued in each and every one of us. All the best.